liquefied natural gas, or LNG.
Right now, it's helping power lives around the world. It's flexible, easily moved wherever it's needed. It's supporting countries with a secure energy supply.
But what is LNG? And why is it so important to countries like India? I'm Kunal,
cricket fanatic, part-time musician, and head of campaigns at Shell. I grew up in the UK, but with Indian parents and family still scattered around the country, India holds a special interest and place for me. Now, after nearly a decade, I'm heading back to India to see how one of the world's fastest growing economies is securing energy to power its future. I'm flying into Delhi, the country's capital, hoping to speak to a senior government official about LNG. Then, it's over to the west coast and the port city of Surat to get a look at how LNG arrives in the country. But before I talk to anyone, I want to understand what's driving India's interest in natural gas and LNG. Currently, coal supplies more than half of the energy here. But like many countries around the world, India is trying to find lower carbon alternatives. It's already committed to growing its renewable energy capacity to 500 gigawatts by 2030.
By the same year, India aims for natural gas to account for 15% of its energy supply. That's more than double what it is today. But why does this all matter?
I've been lucky enough to be given time with Pankaj Jain, India's secretary at the Ministry for Petroleum and Natural Gas, to ask about the country's changing energy mix.
What India aims for is growth in natural gas consumption, going up well beyond the current growth that we see.
And Secretary, what is it about natural gas in particular that makes it so appealing here in India?
LNG is a very valuable alternative when it works in tandem with renewables, and particularly in both hard-to-abate and hard-to-electrify sectors, especially in manufacturing. It's about giving us flexibility. Particularly when we use LNG in terms of abating emissions in lieu of coal.
The Secretary made it clear that India's expanding industrial sector is contributing to a huge surge in energy demand. And while India's own gas production is helping meet this, imported LNG is also needed in the mix. But before we go on, here's a quick reminder of what LNG, or liquefied natural gas, actually is. In short, LNG is natural gas turned into liquid by cooling it to around minus 162 degrees Celsius. This shrinks its volume 600 times, like compressing a beach ball into a ping pong ball, making it far easier to move wherever it's needed. Think of it as natural gas that's cooled, condensed, and shipped.
But why are so many countries drawing on LNG?
And why now? I asked my colleague and Shell's chief economist, Mallika Ishwaran.
Countries are looking to see how they can develop their domestic resources, whether that's fossil or renewables. But they're also looking to see how they can diversify the sources of imported energy.
So more countries are looking to import more natural gas in the form of LNG.
Yes, global LNG trade has been increasing over the last few decades. In fact, the size of the market has increased more than 70% since 2010.
Now understanding LNG's role in India's energy mix, I travelled from Delhi to India's Gujarat coast, the port city of Surat, and Shell Hazira LNG terminal to learn more. Shell's Hazira terminal has the capacity to import up to 5 million tonnes of LNG a year. All of it arrives by specially designed LNG carriers. And this really comes to life when you see it firsthand.
This ship behind me has just docked in from thousands of miles away. It contains gas produced in one part of the world, cooled to a liquefied state.
And then, when it arrives in country, it's pressurized and warmed using seawater to turn it back into gas before distribution to customers across India. Customers like GAIL India, a state-owned energy firm that is one of India's largest distributors of natural gas. I visited their director of marketing, Shri Sanjay Kumar, and asked why the gas coming from Hazira is so important.
Thank you, Kunal. Located on the western coast, this terminal plays a pivotal role as a crucial entry point for the country's energy needs. We are proud to mark a key milestone this year, which will be our 100th LNG cargo at Hazira. As India's demand for natural gas continues to grow, we look forward to deepening this strategic alliance with Shell India in the years ahead.
And customers like ArcelorMittal Nippon Steel India, which happens to have a steel plant right next door to Hazira. I met with their CEO, Dilip Oommen, to find out more.
Dilip, I'm intrigued as to why this steel plant is drawing down on LNG.
Natural gas offers lower emissions compared to coal. We, as a leading and responsible steel manufacturer, primarily use natural gas in the iron making process. It helps us decarbonize the steel making process and supports India's net zero targets. This provides the reliable energy we need to keep our business running.
Speaking to government economists and customers, it's becoming increasingly clear that imported LNG offers a range of benefits to countries like India. It helps provide energy security, it offers a lower carbon alternative to coal, and it can partner with renewables.
Before heading back to the UK, I'm making one final stop in Mumbai to ask Nakul Raheja, country head of Shell Energy India, just why Hazira and LNG are so important to the country's future.
What we do here in India via Hazira helps us connect supply and demand, helps us impact people's lives at scale, and helps us make a difference by building the energy system of the future.
What a trip, and what a privilege.
Returning to India has given me the chance to catch up with family, and I even got to play some cricket.
Most importantly, I learned more about the energy journey India is on and how Shell is helping.
To support its soaring economy and population, I've learned this country is looking to LNG for energy security to help diversify its energy mix,
powering lives and economic progress.